Hi, this is Dr. Patrick Cunningham, Associate Professor of Mechanical Engineering at Rose-Hulman Institute of Technology. Welcome back to the Skillful Learning Series on Metacognition. Recall that metacognition is the knowledge and regulation of our own thinking processes. In this video, Planning for Our Thinking, we will focus on how we can make intentional plans for the effortful mental processing required for learning, which is part of metacognitive regulation. Metacognitive planning is drawing on our metacognitive knowledge in preparation for a learning experience. For example, an assignment, an exam, a study session, or a course. We do this by setting goals and selecting strategies. Our strategies should align with our learning goals, match the task, and be consistent with how we learn. That is, how we build and enrich our knowledge frameworks. Making time to plan for our learning sets us up for success. We learn on purpose, not by accident. Let's check in with Joe and Sue to see how they are executing metacognitive planning in their improved study plans for the next exam. In completing his exam wrapper for the last exam, Joe recognized that cramming and losing sleep were costing him in the long run, and he vowed to improve his studying. A week before the next exam, Joe set up a distributed study schedule, 35 minutes per night for 4 nights, then 1.5 hours each of the last 2 nights before the exam. He collected and organized several old exams, planning to work blank problems and to explore variations on solved problems. Sue, on the other hand, arranged a study plan similar to the last exam, setting aside about 1 hour each morning between classes for the 5 weekdays prior to the next exam. During 4 of the study sessions, Sue planned to solve 1 to 2 problems completely and set up 3 to 4 more problems, that is, to identify principles, draw diagrams, and state assumptions. Sue knew she struggled with setting up problems correctly and efficiently, and she wanted to get better at it. She was confident she could do the math after getting the correct setup. She also planned to make up 2 problems applying course principles to real applications in which she had interest. In 1 morning session and an extra 1 hour session on the weekend, she planned to meet with a friend to share and solve the problems they made up, and to discuss their solutions to these and other problems. Joe and Sue have made some good plans. Have you ever been so intentional about your study plans? Perhaps you have set up plans with good intentions, but then a homework set for another class takes longer than you expected, and you get thrown off your plan. Joe and Sue have good intentions with their plans too, but Joe could improve his plans with more focused study goals, and Sue needs to address the factors that affected her poor performance on the last exam. Let's examine Joe and Sue's plans more closely and explore how we can do better sticking with our plans. There are several good features in Joe's plan. He is distributing his practice over multiple days and he is recalling concepts as he works blank problems. This strengthens his memory. Exploring what-if scenarios with solved problems is a form of elaboration, which helps him build connections to the new concepts. However, there are 3 main shortcomings with Joe's plan. First, he is only studying at night when he is tired and he isn't thinking clearly. During the day, when he has time between classes, Joe likes to relax. For example, he plays video games, watches TV or videos, and surfs the web. He isn't taking advantage of the time when his mind is sharpest, for him, mid-afternoon. This makes his studying less efficient and effective and results in him staying up late and losing valuable sleep. Second, Joe's goals for his study sessions are unclear. He isn't being very strategic. What does he really want to get out of his study time? Joe is practicing complete problems, whether or not he needs to practice all the parts. He recognizes that identifying principles and drawing diagrams come easily to him, but he struggles with making appropriate assumptions and manipulating equations. He could use his limited study time more effectively by focusing on the elements he struggles with. Learning goals that address his difficulties and that he can test himself against would help him do this. SMART goals are a good model for setting such goals. S-M-A-R-T stands for specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bound. Search for SMART goals to learn more. Finally, Joe's study plan isn't very diverse. He is working problems and examining solved problems. This is only practicing one way of accessing and using the information. Just as athletes and musicians use a variety of exercises in preparation for their performances, it is beneficial to vary the ways we engage the concepts we are trying to learn. Think of it this way: singular practice only provides one route to the information, while using various strategies creates multiple routes to the information, making concepts and ideas easier to recall and apply in different situations. Sue's study plan has more specific goals focused on what she needs, practicing setting up problems. She is also leveraging her clearest thinking time, morning for her, and is employing a variety of strategies that get her thinking about the course material in different ways. Additionally, she is making her learning memorable by making up problems for real applications in which she has interest. However, Sue is not addressing the primary factors that interrupted her thinking and contributed to her poor performance on the last exam. That is, the emotional distress from her mom's phone call and not eating breakfast. Depending on the nature of the relationship and the emotional issues, Sue could talk with her mom about how to avoid this in the future. She could also consider setting better boundaries with her mom or counseling to help her to deal with the situation. To address missing breakfast, Sue could buy protein bars and fruit or other healthy, quick, and easy snacks to take with her when she is running short on time for meals. Joe and Sue have taken the important step of planning for their learning, and we have examined specific improvements to their plans, namely SMART goals, using multiple strategies, capitalizing on their clearest thinking time, and targeting their problem areas. But how do we get better at following through on our plans? Dr. Sandra Bon Chapman, brain researcher at University of Texas at Dallas, has found that strategic focus is critical for accomplishing our goals amid the flurry of activities in life. She cites a quote she once heard: "When you are hunting elephants, don't get distracted chasing rabbits. The elephants are our most important goals, like learning material to do well in a class or prepare for a career. They need regular and focused, distraction-free work time. The rabbits are the myriad of little tasks that don't attach to our big goals. Some rabbit tasks need to get done as well, like laundry, but we need to keep them contained." Dr. Chapman suggests, and my experience confirms, that we can deal with 2 to 3 elephants in a day. Plan your elephants and your rabbits for each day so that you can accomplish your learning goals. There is time to address necessary rabbit tasks and to take breaks, but don't let them get in the way of achieving your elephant tasks. In summary, we need to engage in intentional metacognitive planning to be more successful. We need to learn on purpose and not just react to what is going on around us or what is happening to us. Metacognitive planning should involve making SMART goals, coherently blending our metacognitive knowledge of persons, tasks, and strategies, and identifying our elephants and rabbits. Make time to plan for your learning so that you learn on purpose. Set SMART goals for yourself. Align your learning goals and strategies. Use what you know about yourself and how learning works. Make sure your strategies address your learning goals and the goals of the task. Expand your strategies to enrich your learning. Give your elephants regular, distraction-free time to achieve your big goals. It will feel hard to make these focused choices at first, but the elephant tasks are the paths to achieving our big goals. Thank you again for your attention as we have examined metacognitive planning. I hope you find these tools helpful as you prepare for your next learning experience.